Now, a bunch of good reasons to use Google Tag Manager server side. It's a great way to take greater control of your data flows on how your data goes from your website to your tracking tools. And you can get higher quality data through that. Everything is kept in the first party context when you set up your domain. And that way you can also get around ad blockers or other tracking prevention methods. But you might be hesitant to try out Google Tag Manager server side. For one, the costs are quite high if you run a Google Cloud App Engine and you have to deal with all the setup work, but then also administering this kind of new platform, this server, which lives in the Google Cloud platform. But what if I told you there is actually a better way? In this video, I'm going to show you a way you can easily get started with Google Tag Manager in just a few minutes, and it's even for free. So let's go over to the computer and I'll show you what I mean. Here I'm inside of Google Tag Manager already, and we have a Google Analytics 4 tag that we set up. This is my client-side implementation, so it's implemented on my demo shop as normally and sending data over to Google Analytics. Now we want to move that tag actually to be server-side. So we send that data over to our tagging server first, and from there it's forwarded on to Google Analytics. For that, we need to install a Google Tag Manager server-side instance. So let's go over here and I'm going to create a new container and let's call this GTM server-side. So then we choose server right here and we can create that Google Tag Manager instance. Now, this is just the interface. We need to now connect this to our tagging server actually. And the way that Google Tag Manager recommends us to do this is on the Google Cloud platform, which you can automatically get started with pretty easily, but you need to set this up with your Google Cloud platform and you need to administer that server later. Also upgrade this if you want to put this into production. What we want to do is actually manually provision a tagging server. Now you could set that up in other cloud platforms like on AWS, on Amazon's cloud or the other clouds that are out there, but it also gets similar complicated. So why isn't there a service that actually takes that hard part over for us? Well, there is. It's called Stape and you can find it at stape.io, where you can get started for free and set up your managed server environment. So it's a hosted kind of server that you can install Google Tag Manager on. And the pricing is also pretty friendly. So you can get started with a free account with 10,000 requests. If you want to upgrade and use this in production, you can go as low as $20 a month. And that is obviously much different than the $120 that you should be spending on an app engine if you have three instances, which Google Tag Manager recommends. So you can get started really easily for free and put in your email address. Confirm this, obviously. I went ahead and already created an account for us here. So we're going to go ahead and log in. And once you're logged in, you will get your GTM containers that you already have set up. So we have some demo accounts here. What I want to show you is creating a new container. You can give this a name. Again, this is our demo shop server. And now you need to put in your container configuration. So where do I find that? That's exactly what we saw here when we wanted to manually set that up here. So we can copy that. If you already have a container set up, you can always go to admin section and then install Google Tag Manager. Again, you get these two options here and you can copy this ID, which Stape needs. So we'll put that in. And then you can choose where to actually locate your instance. Let's put this here into Germany and we can use a custom domain. This is very important if you want to have first party requests. For that, you need to change your name servers around and point that domain to this address. I won't be doing this for right now. And all you need to do is create here and then it's deploying my instance. And in a second, we'll get a URL that we can put into our admin section. Again, right here under container settings, we need to have our server container URL. So once Stape is done and it's running, then we get here our configuration, identifier, API key, but also our tagging server URL. So we're going to copy this one and put this in place. So let's save this. And this is now all updated. We can go back to the workspace and actually click on preview. Now this will open up our new Stape URL that has our Stape server. We can actually send over a request here to our tagging server. Let's do that. And it's totally normal that you see an error here, but inside of our preview mode, we see here that a request just came in and I requested this URL. So this is a fully fledged Google Tag Manager server at this moment already. So all I need to do in order to send over my request from the client side is to go into my Google Analytics 4 tag and let's here send to server container with my Google Analytics 4 tag. We'll enter this one here, and all the data that normally went to Google Analytics servers is now sent to this URL. So I'm going to save this. Let's preview this. And here we go. Our tag is deployed on our website right here. We should see inside of our preview mode of our tagging server side instance that there is a new event called page view. No request was claimed yet. We need to set it up in a client, which is done by default. Now we just need to send it on to our GA4. So all I need to do is go over to tags inside of our server side. Very important to distinguish these. And we'll set this up so it actually sends over to Google Analytics 4. All we need is the measurement ID. So let's copy that from our old tag here. And we'll put this in here. You can redact visitor IP. You can change the event names around. You can manipulate the request that is going through. And that is the power of Google Tag Manager server side, because we have full control over the request that is sent over to Google Analytics 4 at this point. So let's just give this a name here. And I'm just going to go with all pages, although this would be all events in terms of Google Tag Manager. Whatever is coming in here, it will forward this on to Google Analytics 4. So again, let's refresh, first of all, our server-side instance. So that is fresh. And then also our client-side instance. And this will reload our demo shop. A request is sent, this time not to our Google Analytics server, but directly to our server-side instance. And here we see that a page view came in and even a user engagement, and it's forwarded over to Google Analytics 4. And we'll also be able to see this inside of our Google Analytics 4 debug view right here. So as you can see, Stape is a very quick solution in order to get up and running with GTM server side. And they give you a handy interface right here where you can see how many requests you have already been sending over from a perspective of the limitations that you have on your plan. Obviously, if you want to put this in full production and have a little bit more requests, and this is counted by how many requests are actually sent over to the server instances. So if you have multiple tools installed, that will be multiple requests that will be sent with every page view that is, for example, generated. So you need to keep that in mind, and then you would be upgrading your plan. But as you have seen, it's quite affordable to get started with this, even for smaller businesses. So overall, I think you can see that Stape.io makes it so much easier to deploy Google Tag Manager server side, get started with it, and even just try it out. If you want to sign up to this platform, we have a link down below where you'll also get a discount if you sign up to one of the paid plans as well. Now, I'd love to hear from you what kind of questions you might still have around Google Tag Manager server side. You can maybe make another video on this one, but it's so much easier to get started right now than creating something in the Google Cloud platform with the app engine and trying to administer this all. So Stape kind of takes this over for you, this particular step, and I think it's quite useful. This service has helped us out with many different clients already, so I wanted to feature it here as well. Now, I hope this video helped you out. Click that thumbs up button if you like this video to help us out to spread this in the algorithm as well. My name is Julian. Till next time.